Hey guys! I hope that you guys are doing amazing wherever you are in the world. My name is Boom Shikha, and as always, I welcome you to my channel. I'm so grateful that you guys are listening, subscribing, and commenting. I really appreciate the support. And if you're interested in supporting me further, you can go to my Ko-fi link, kofi.com/boomshikha, and you can give me a one-off donation, or you can go to my Patreon link. Both of those links are in the description below. In this video, I want to speak to you guys about control. That is one of our main things as an INFJ. I think that we're trying in this world that seems like it's completely lost control and just out of control. Everything just going into madness zone, and everything feels like it's just out of our power. In order to gain a little bit of power, in order to gain a little bit of control, a semblance of control, INFJs are always trying to do certain things, little things, minor things, but that gives them a sense of being back in control. And especially if their environment is very chaotic or the people around them are very chaotic, we do more of these things that make us feel like we have control over our lives, over ourselves, over our environment, over whatever it might be, right? For example, recently I was staying with a friend of mine in England, in London, and she's a good friend of mine from university. We used to work together a long time ago, 15 years ago or so. And she has three children, and they are rambunctious. They are a bundle of joy, beautiful, beautiful kids, but they have so much energy. And I'm saying that from a person that I think I have a lot of energy, but wow, they have a lot of energy. And so they're like a whirlwind. They're basically like a hurricane. Each room that they pass through, you know, the room is clean before they come into it, and they pass through it, and everything is a complete mess. And of course, my room was not safe from it. And so I had my suitcase on the ground and I had my clothes in there. Thankfully, they didn't touch my laptop, but because I yelled at them about it, I'm like, do not touch. This is important. If you break it, I'm going to kill you guys. I literally said those words. I'm sure that was not allowed. But I was like, this is important stuff. And especially my mouse. I was like, you know, this is a mouse and this is electronic. And if you do anything to it, I'm going to kill you guys. I'm not obviously meant to be a parent. But anyways, so they didn't touch my laptop, but my suitcase filled with clothes. By the time, you know, I'd leave for the day, I'd go away and I'd come back and they'd be sleeping sometimes. And I'd go into my room, the room that my friend gave to me. And it's basically like all the things in my suitcase were on the ground. They were just all taken out and people, they'd kind of rummage through it. And I just thought it was funny because there was nothing valuable in there. As long as they didn't touch my laptop, I was fine, my laptop and mouse. But it was just funny because they have a lot of energy. But that was absolute chaos. My environment was in complete chaos. And that's one of the reasons why I live by myself. And that's one of the reasons why I recommend INFJs to live by yourself, is because we need a non-chaotic environment if we're going to feel at peace with ourselves. Because our minds are so chaotic, in the fact that there's so much going on in our heads, we need to ensure that at least our environments are non-chaotic in a certain way. So the world that I live in right now in Chiang Mai, this apartment is very minimalistic, very few things in there. So it's very hard, it's extremely hard to make it messy because there's just not enough stuff here to make it messy. And I just don't have enough clothes to make it messy. I just don't have enough stuff in general. But that's a choice I've made so that my environment is perfectly clean and non-chaotic. And so you can walk into my room right now, it's very clean, it's very non-chaotic because that gives me a semblance of control. It makes me feel, okay, cool. If my environment is under control, then I can feel a little bit better about my own life. And I can feel like, okay, I can do my creative work without wanting to worry about, oh my God, everything is everywhere and I can't do anything. I can't pay attention to anything. And that's what happens to INFJs a lot of times. Of course, you guys perhaps live in more chaotic situations than I do. And I remember when I was in England, I was able to do very little work. And I always felt like I was in a mad rush because I just felt like there was so much chaos everywhere. People screaming, children screaming, things everywhere, thrown about, strewn about. And I'm just thinking to myself, oh my God, I can't do any work here. It just felt very, very chaotic to me. Now, of course, when I'm back in Chiang Mai, I can feel my peace returning and I can feel my creativity returning as well because it's not chaotic anymore. It's calm. It's peaceful. Not that I'm saying there's anything wrong with staying in a chaotic environment. And I was grateful my friend let me stay with her. But of course, this is an INFJ thing. And I used to tell her, I'm like, I don't know how you do it. I have no idea. I wouldn't be able to do it. One of the reasons why I don't have kids as well is because of this. I just cannot deal with a chaotic environment. But I'm sure a lot of you guys are in INFJs and have children and have very chaotic environments or chaotic jobs or chaotic lives in general. And so the way that we as INFJs gain some control over our environment if we're not able to do anything about it. So if you have children as an INFJ, you can't really do anything about the fact that your life is going to be chaotic. Life with children is chaotic. It's just the way it is. Or if you have a family, it's just going to be the way it is. Or if you have drama in your life, it's just the way it is. And so what I notice I do as an INFJ in order to bring more control into my life is I use to-do lists. I use Excel sheets. I control things by making sure that I write things down. I control things by making sure that I organize things more and more and more and more so all the time. I control things by becoming more and more minimalist. The less stuff I have, the less I have to organize. I control things by running away from relationships and being single. I control things by staying in my apartment and avoiding any kind of dramatic situation or any kind of relationships outside or my friends or family as much as possible. And that's what INFJs do. We have this extreme need, this desire for peace in our environment, non-chaos, because if we have a chaotic environment and our minds are chaotic as well, then it's just chaos all over and we're not able to feel any peace at all, right? And for us to control our chaotic minds, the only way I've found to do anything with it is meditation. But even with meditation, my mind is still all over the freaking place. And I'm always thinking, I'm always dreaming, I'm always creating up new scenarios in my head. And so in order to have some control in my life, I make sure that my environment is extremely clean, extremely non-chaotic. My relationships are extremely non-chaotic. Anyone that brings drama into my life, I cut them off. Anyone that brings any kind of chaos into my life, I try to run away from them in the opposite direction. And as much as possible, I try to have as many to-do lists as possible so that I have a clear schedule for my day. I know exactly what I'm supposed to do. And I have lists and lists and lists for all the things that are coming in the future that I need to do, all the people that I should be meeting or need to hang out with. You know, if I need to make a phone call to my parents, I'll put it on my list to do. If I have to make a payment for a bill, I'll put it on my list so that nothing is in my chaotic head. Everything is in a to-do list. Everything is kind of controlled in a way, and that as an INFJ gives me a lot of solace. It gives me a lot of peace. And that's one of the reasons why I think they're called J's, judgment J's, is because of the fact that we do this. We like to have control in our lives. We like to know that our lives and environments are controlled in some manner. Now, of course, life happens. That's the whole point of it. That's the reason we live on this planet. That's the reason we are human beings, we're conscious. But life happens, you know, things will, no matter how much you try to control them, no matter how many to-do lists you have, no matter how many Excel sheets you make up, things will happen. Your toaster will break down, even though you take care of it. You know, your kettle will burn out one day, even though you've been taking good care of it. Your wallet will tear up one day, even though you've been taking good care of it. You know, things like that. I mean, like, no matter what you do, eventually chaos comes into your life because that's what the world is about. You know, it always moves towards chaos. We can do as much as possible, but eventually we have to realize that things will happen. But what happens with an INFJ is that, you know, we'll have control, we'll do everything perfectly as much as possible, and then something goes wrong. And then we'll blame ourselves for it, and we'll be like, oh my God, if I'd only done this right, if I'd only done that right. But I want to remind you guys that yes, control is important. Yes, it's very important for you to take care of your environment, extremely important for you to take care of your job situation and your relationship situation so that you're not bringing extra chaos into your life. Good, do all of that, but realize that life happens and shit happens. Oops, I shouldn't have said that word. Things happen, bleep happens, and you just are unable to control all of these situations. No matter how hard you try, life will happen. It's just the way it is, right? And so instead of going crazy about it, just realize that life is happening. And you're going to just have to let it happen, relax into it, let it abandon yourself into it. Just don't completely let it all go, but realize that you can't control everything. And then life does happen. Don't blame yourself for it. Don't blame yourself. You did everything you could. You're an INFJ, and I'm sure you did the best you could. But sometimes your best is not good enough. Sometimes life will still kick you in the butt because some things just happen. You know, it's just the way it is. I was going to use a bad word. but I'm understanding I shouldn't. So yeah, so things happen. And so I really want you guys to remember that, especially the next time something happens. You're like, but I thought I took care of everything. I thought I controlled everything on my end. How could this happen? Well, as I said, life happens. That's just the way it is. It's nothing to do with you. It's not your fault. It's just the way life is. Okay? I hope this makes sense. I hope I was able to explain myself to you. If you guys have any questions about it, please do comment below and I'll do a follow-up video on this. And if you guys are interested in supporting me further, you can do that by going to my Ko-fi link, kofi.com/boomshikha, and you can give me a one-off donation. And I shall see you guys the next time around. Bye for now.